Hey everyone, just another update on the watering system, or on the automatic gardening system. So this is the same valve pack I showed in the last video, only now I have the house water selector valve, I have an intake for the tank when it's set up, and I have a nice flow rate sensor and a new piece of wire. I will be attaching more sensors to that in the future, but for now it's just that sensor. And then here we have the same zone 1, 2, and 3 valves. Now all the zones are actually hooked up and functional. There's three different zones that we water at any given time. But anyway, I kind of wanted to show that all this is working. It's raining, so you won't be able to see any of the stuff or any of the drippers running because, you know, it's raining. But anyway, so I'm going to log into my into the controller here. Yep. Okay. Sorry, one-handed typing sucks. Okay. Boom. All right, cool. And now you can see the updated system status display. Some new things. I'm not sure if I had this in the last video. The control system, which is the Raspberry Pi status, got the last time we got a broadcast from it and the CPU temperature. We also have all the valves and elements active except for the tank, which is obviously not installed yet. But I do now have a very, very basic if this then that engine built into this guy, and it stores those, you store those entries in the database, and it'll pull once every 5 seconds to see if you want to execute a new action. And I do believe I have an active test one right now, but I have a rain delay set. So if you have a rain delay set, it'll actually scan the array of controls. Here, I'm going to move. It'll actually scan the array of controls in the system to see if the controls are directly related to watering. And if the controls are directly related to watering, then it'll actually, then it'll actually turn the controls off, or the valves off, or whatever. Or it won't allow the if this, then that engine to activate said valves. So that's how you prevent it from watering when you set a rain delay. Of course, that can be overridden by the user. If you want, for whatever reason. But let's see here. Boom. All right. A little bit less noisy in here. But anyway. So now, if I, from the command line utility. Oh, if I can spell it right. One-handed typing. Yuck. Okay. So now I'm going to switch the rain delay that I have set off. Rain delay 0. You'll notice that the test event that I have installed on the engine should go into effect, and you should see the... There we go. The house water valve open and zone 3 open. So yeah, and then you can see water is flowing, and I've got it in both liters per minute and gallons per minute, the flow rate. So this is actually pretty cool. What that does is the Raspberry Pi has an interrupt set up on it, so every time the flow rate sensor spins once, it creates a single pulse that the Raspberry Pi picks up, and it accumulates those pulses over 1 second and determines the flow rate. And then that's broadcast once every 5 seconds to the web page where it updates. So then you'll see me turn my rain delay back on, and I'll just turn it on for 12 hours since we're expecting rain for a while. Whoops, daisies. There we go. Hours. You have to give it the length of time in hours. So it sent the command. Yeah, valve's already shut off. Flow rate should stop in a moment. It takes a little bit for the water to stop moving because the valves actually don't close immediately. They take a couple seconds to close. But anyway, yeah, so that's basically the system right now. Still need to develop the front end, but I'm totally going to rewrite the if this, then that engine. Just super not satisfied with where it is, and I think I can do better. So I'm going to have to get that going. But anyway, yeah, this is the update so far. And got a bunch of extra functionality. I've got to add a couple more things to the display here. You know, so for example, I want it to show if the rain delay is active, you know, or whatever. But I really do like the idea of being able to tag sensors or controls with certain values and then selectively, you know, manipulate those controls. So like, for example, let's pretend that this were deployed in a greenhouse, you know. And okay, well, it's, you know, sure, there's a little bit of rain, so I don't, or that's not a good example. But anyway, let's just pretend that there are controls that are directly related to outdoor watering, and then some controls that are not. And you only want some of those controls to be manipulated during a rain, you know, when you set the rain delay. So that way, if you tag your input controls with watering, then it knows if there's a rain delay, that control needs to be in a certain state. So I'd like to do more of that, and I would also like to be able to, you know, integrate external APIs as kind of virtual sensors and say like, oh, well, you know, if it's raining right, or, you know, if I'm expecting rain in the next 8 hours, you know, from some probability, then perhaps I should, you know, just not water this morning or whatever. And then you can set the rain delay automatically from another quote-unquote sensor. And it would also be nice to set up alarms if all my valves are closed, supposedly, and then this thing is still going, for example, you know, for more than, like, we'll say 10 seconds, then I know I probably have a leak or a broken pipe or something somewhere, and I should attend to that so I can actually throw an alarm condition for that sensor. But anyway, that's where we're at so far, and, you know, decent amount of work left to go, but I've got a pretty solid base finally. Cheers.